recordings later also. Okay, so don't worry. Okay. So I need to discuss here. Yeah, there are the transcription which is coming. I just keep it off. So I just keep it off that live captions. Okay, but don't worry. That will be visible later on. If you want to say, if you want something, you know, the lectures that you need in terms of written part, okay, I will provide that sheet later on. Okay, there is a facility while discussing, I can put on some live recording as well as, you know, there are the live captions. So the discussions which is going on, that will be a transcribed in terms of the writing part that we called as a transcription. So that I will provide later if some of you need that, okay, later, those who have missed. So already I started the lecture yesterday, but I think that we should wait for next week to start my actual lectures, okay? And we'll discuss about this OBE first, okay? And the internal evaluation process. Some of people will say that, oh, it's always be a kind of a repetition, but remember, it is a very important thing at this point, okay, to understand how's your evaluation process, because you are new in the graduation and you are new in the autonomy process itself, okay? And this is the something we should orient you people, okay? The teachers are there to orient along this direction, to understand what is the autonomous structure we have, how the evaluation is conducted, which is different than the university examination some way, okay? And there is, I say, outcome-based education model on which all those evaluation to be carried out, okay? So you do not need to do too much, you mean to say, tension out of it, but the process you should understand, okay? The system you need to understand. That is very important here. So, yeah, so already I mentioned about the evaluation process. The evaluation process mostly involves your internal evaluation, and that we called as a concurrent evaluation, okay? And that consists of mostly the the CE1, what we called as a concurrent evaluation one, okay? And that we divide into two parts, so say 10 mark and 15 mark. So already I mentioned about, you know, the way of the examination we need to conduct, that is flexible way. And in the what we call as academic calendar, we provide also what are the types of CE will be there. So generally this concurrent evaluation is on the basis of how much the lectures hours we engaged, okay, in actual classroom, and typically the examination that we will conduct on the basis of what we conducted in the class, okay? So just like in a 1 month, like in a process, suppose there will be an examination of CE1, so at least, you know, the first chapter, or you say first unit or first module of our course 1, okay, will be covered. So like that, there will be examination. The examination may be an assignment type of the work, the numericals problems that you need to solve, just like for an example, the moment of inertia chapter we are discussing. Okay, so you need to solve some problem based on that, the knowledge earlier you gained on that. Okay, and there are the unsolved problems, okay, you need to solve. So that will be classified as a 10 mark CE1, okay? And there are 15 marks also, which we called as CET2, okay? Like CET1 is supposed to be called 10 mark, which is of, I say, kind of assignment, okay? There may be CET2 of 15 marks, which is probably we will conducting some kind of again a test. Okay, since we are in the online mode, we always prefer to have the MCQ type of questions. Okay, but let's people, you come with your, because this is a group of more people. So right now, 100 students are in the classroom. So it is very difficult, you know, to conduct different type of assessment by a single teacher, okay, of these 100 students. So different type of assignment means different type of work. Suppose I want to conduct your open book test or some kind of seminar or some kind of, you know, so that is a possible, I mean to say, conducting the various type of examinations, okay, is possible, but written examination also. So type of examination, there are different way of taking the examination, but that is possible only when there is a certain group and which is coming offline and they will conduct like that. But easiest way, we will conduct the MCQ type of a test. So we will conduct that also in the course of time. That's I called as a CET2 of 15 marks again. Okay, so 10 plus 15, that becomes your 25, that is your CE1. Okay, and generally the 50% of the syllabus, that is going to be a finish till that time. Okay, so like two modules we will be covering in this particular time. This is just be a 3 month semester pattern, okay, for one course, like you have other course, but just like we will finish the 50% in 1.5 month, okay, and remaining 1.5 month, we will finish the remaining portions of the syllabus, okay, and that will be coming under the what, CE2. So when I say concurrent evaluation 2, so it is a compulsory examination again. You need to go through the ERP model. There is a separate software, or you say in terms of, you say some webs, some kind of a software where we are conducting all those examinations, okay, and that we called as ERP, okay, and you need to have login and all those things. I know still you are, people are joining with the login of the guest mode, okay, because you haven't got those deccansociety.org, okay, kind of ID, which is required to log in all those Microsoft Teams or the other products available with the Microsoft Teams. Okay, so that's the things are also equally important, but later on, once the things will be finalized from the college, they will provide you all such a, you know, kind of IDs, okay, user IDs to your mail, and then you can use that user IDs for login those Microsoft Teams, and you can authentically join those ERP system with that and give your examination. So the all set of instructions will be provided to you. Don't worry right now, okay? But right now, I'll just say that this lecture, I must devote it to understand, okay, what the autonomous system we will providing to you and what we actually expecting from you people, okay, through this examination. So these things I'm going to discuss with you today. Okay, so when I say CE2, so this is on the ERP system, and that is of 25 marks of ERP, I mean to say MCQ type of questions that is given to you. And somebody asked me that day also, sir, all those questions are on the MCQ types. Are you going to provide a kind of question bank? Okay. No such a kind of a question bank that we do not need to open up, because this is the server on which all kinds of examinations are going to be conducted. So those are the, what I say, secret things, we just keep it. But I say the practice of the examinations, okay, such a kinds of examination that we can conduct, okay, equally on that system. Once you got, you know, login your passwords, once you receive, we can practice some model type of questions, similar type of questions we can discuss, okay? So this we are going to conduct in your CE1 and CE2, and that your 25, 10 plus 15 CE1 and plus 25, that is your CE2, becomes your complete 50 marks kind of evaluation. So for CE2, till the examination is announced, I say concurrent evaluation 2 will be announced, our syllabus, the teaching part will be a finish. Okay, so 75 to 80, 90% get finished, don't worry. And you have all the, you know, a syllabus, complete syllabus for your CE2. And that is very important again, because you all cover CE1, CE2, all syllabus, and complete internal evaluation is done. And now there will be the end semester examination, which is of 50 marks. So this end semester examination again will be conducted by me, means us only, on that ERP system. And here again, it is a MCQ type of a question, since we are in on the online mode. And then you say that this 50 marks question, yes, this 50 marks questions, this 50 marks means each question is of each 1 mark, that is a policy we decided, okay. And there are the certain levels of questions, so starting from the, you know, easy, difficult, or the medium level, but the marking scheme, okay, remains to be a same, okay. However, the time we will provide to you, that is of 1 hour, okay. In 60 minutes, like, you want to give the answers of those 50 questions, okay, and you need to attempt that in a time. So in the ERP system, one thing is like that, you have to log in time, but that clock, once it will be starting on whatever be the time, and in between you have some difficulty also. So don't worry, there are all difficulties because of the internet connections and everything. Okay. But whatever the questions you are attempted, that remains to be there. Okay. So whatever you attempted, solved, unsolved, okay, that from that point, it will be a continued. Okay. But the clock that will be given to the system, like suppose there is an examination from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Okay. So that exam will be automatically clock started with the 12 p.m. Okay, and automatically, I mean to say, started at off at 1 p.m. So that's in duration. You need to always be a good sense. I mean to say, you have to have good softwares, your computer, laptop, everything is in the good kind of a conditions, your browser, okay, internet facility, what the modem you have, everything that will be a good so there will be no disturbance in a what attending the particular examination. So you should always be a technically sound in that kind of thing. So mostly the students we observed in this 1.5 year is a problem of mostly the internet connections. Okay, so even though in for the 1 second, there is a lag of, you know, a disconnection, the examination gets stops from your side. However, the clock will be a continue from the examination side. Okay, but don't worry, just keep it off your that window, okay, of that ERP system, and just again log in, okay. So earlier what you have attempted, that will be remain as it is, and you can solve further. That is a, we say, complete luck kind of a thing, okay, where we have all those control, okay. And yeah, there are some questions from Chinmay. What you have raised hands. Is there any question regarding this? Yes, you can ask me. Otherwise, you can just down your hand. Chinmay Pawar. Okay. So people, this system is new for you, okay, to understand this particular, you know, system, the online, offline, and everything. We are in the now, right now, the virtual mode. So all the things we are communicating online. So be techno savvy, okay? That is the essential condition right now in this pandemic period, okay? Yeah, Abhishek Dengade is asking, what are the credit points? I come to that, okay, also. what do you mean by the credit points you have? So regarding evaluation, I want to just finish everything, and then I will discuss about the credits lectures that been allotted for the particular course. Okay. So yeah, there is any questions regarding the examination? I think I have covered mostly the CE and ESC kind of thing. So CE, I say internal assessment that we called as a concurrent evaluation, which is of again 50 marks, and the end semester examination that is of 50 marks, 50 plus 50. Okay. So out of 50 internal assessment, total should be a passing of 20 marks, and out of 50 external end semester examination, you need to have minimum 20 to pass that examination. Okay. So that is a 20 marks is a passing marks you have for each and every course if you want to pass. So you need to separately pass the internal assessment, that is we called as a concurrent evaluation CE, okay, and you need to separately pass your external examination, okay, and that's the essential criteria of getting result to be a pass, okay. Otherwise, if you don't bother about the concurrent evaluation and you are just focusing on ESC, and later on you realize that, okay, I haven't got the total marks, okay, like 10 plus 15 plus 25, okay, and that becomes a 50. Out of that 50, I got total less as a 20, less than 20. You need to, you know, be in touch with the teacher, okay, who has conducted all such a test, okay. So if there is a definitely a difficulty during the online kind of things, okay, they will help you, okay. But later on, once the result will come out, okay, see, because look at this concurrent evaluation is finished, okay, not just like, you know, finishing all the syllabus, so suddenly the end semester examination comes over there. So you have a very little time in between, okay. So, and the important thing is that once the syllabus is get finished, okay, you have a same sort of, you know, kind of a questions, okay, that will be appearing to your ESC, the same sort of, because the syllabus is remaining to be the same. So you should be always, but once we will not declare the internal assessment result, we will not conduct the end semester examination. So, but there is a very little time that we will have in between, you know, CE and ESE, okay? So internal assessment and the end semester examination. So be careful about that. And at the same time, we are also conducting your practicals. But since we are in the virtual mode, okay, mostly these practicals are in the demonstrative kind of mode. But hopefully, this year, okay, we will plan, okay, if you are all get vaccinated properly and there is some communication from the central government or a state government, let's see how the things will be a positive in some sense, okay. But this is not in our hand completely, okay. But we will do something good for you people to learn. So you will not learning, taking, doing 100%, but at least 80%, 90%, we can reach to that level, okay. Yeah. So I just take one by one question. What are the credit points? You can write in the chat box, those who are available chatting over there, you can write, or you can raise, ask questions by unmute yourself also. But there are the some questions be written here, okay, regarding the credit points, or what are the credit points. So just yesterday, day before yesterday, first lecture, we go through the syllabus, right? And you have seen there are the two credits which is written to our course, that is the material science course. This particular properties of matter, introduction to mechanics and properties of matter. So mechanics and properties of matter is the name of our course, right? So this particular course has having two credits. Means what? Means what? There are the certain lectures to be allotted, okay, for that course. And if you can finish this course, means you finish means you have done your internal assessment and external end semester examination you have done, means what you earn, that you pass, you got the result, that means you earn 2 credits. So 2 credit points roughly for that syllabus requires almost 36 hours of lecturing. Okay, so it's not just kind of lectures from our side, it's a mix of examinations and everything. Okay, internal assessment, okay, your contribution, okay, in some sense assignment, okay, that all the 36 hours, that means actual hours, we are engaging this particular course to get finished or to get complete. Okay, so this credit points are generally, this is the credit based systems. Okay, it is not just like a mark kind of a thing. So you have to pass this particular FIBSC as a, you know, FIBSC result. So you will earning this much of the what, the credit points. Okay, credit. So these are the credits are fixed to the particular course. And roughly remember that in first year of BSc and second year of BSc, each and every course having, and also in the TYBSC letter, okay, that is in the new syllabus for this batch, okay, all the courses are of 2 credits. Okay, so 2 credits will be given to the what, to one course like that. So like you have a paper one, FIBSC paper one, like mechanics, you will earn 2 credits. You will have 2 credit points for the other course like a thermodynamics. You will have to earn those credits, 2 credit points for the practical course. Like that, this the credits you can earn, okay, compulsory credits. So that is not the choice to you. I mean to say, you will not you cannot take as a choice. It is a compulsory. You have a compulsory to learn these kinds of paper to earn these credits. Getting my point? So these are the 6 credits been allotted in the first semester, and similarly you will have the another 6 credits that is in the next semester. The whole one for first plus two second semester, that becomes your year as a FIBSC year. That is, I'm talking just about the physics only. Okay, the 2 papers in the first semester, 1 practical, 2 papers in the second semester, 1 practical. Okay, and there are the separate examinations. It is not like a year examination, it will always be a semester kind of examination. Why I'm talking every time repeatedly, because I know that these are the students you are here, and later on I will find the new students. Okay, this is the 10-year experience I have. Okay, because mostly the students are there for some time, and new students will be joined the institutes. Okay, this is the admission process through which they are going on. Okay, that is the part, and I know the career of each and everyone. Okay, but do you have some questions regarding the syllabus? I can check one by one. Okay, so I'll discuss about the credits. I have discussed about the exams. Is any scholarship to BSc course 2? I want, this is like a scholarship you are talking about. So so this is not been any type of, we are providing any type of a scholarship to you people, but there are the many external kind of a scholarship you can check it on. Okay, but there are limited, we will need to check those for the UG course, but mostly the college is not providing any typical kind of scholarship, but there are certain scholarship provided by the university. Okay, so please check on, once there will be a notification, once you form eligibility form, you filled it, okay, there probably some kind of a notification, but I don't know exactly the name. Okay, but there is no such a scholarship is actually providing by college to you people. Okay, right now. What will be the paper pattern? So mostly the questions are, I mentioned, okay, MCQ based kind of a questions. Okay, so since we are in the virtual mode and numerical MCQs, okay, since this is the physics, we'll try to solve some problems, numerical problems. Okay, so this type of questions to be there. Okay, and the pattern will be always be a MCQ type of a pattern. But definitely, I say there are the flexible evaluation processes, okay? Some of you people are not done good in that MCQ type of a test, okay? We will discuss if there is a genuine problem, okay? Sort of other type of a test can be conducted, okay? Probably the assignment kind of a work, okay? But I know that most of the assignments are the mass copying, okay? And that's not been the good practice. Okay, so we will always have, you know, to maintain the to have a record to do not have such a, you know, mass copying of each and everyone. Okay, so we will do some kind of examinations, mostly are the MCQ type of paper pack. What kind of exposure we get, we will get in a first year physics? So exposure means what? Look at, since you are in the offline, since we are in the online mode, okay, you are at home and we are working from the college, okay, you are not coming to the laboratory, you are not exposing, you are not having hands-on training, but the exposure kind of a thing generally we can provide to the students in a virtual mode, okay. You will find that there are certain extracurricular activities which can be a possible, okay, conducted by the physics department or any other department like astrophysics or some kind of lectures which is going on, virtual talks, that the way kind of exposure to the another world, okay, other than the teaching can be provided to you. But it's limited, okay, the world is open to you, but the first year student is always exposed with the skills and other things, okay, when they are in the lab, okay, they are personally doing some work, okay, but that is exposure, some kind of faced, some kind of, you know, visit to the labs, institutes, that kind of things we can definitely carry out, okay, in the offline things. So let's see in future, we will have that. I also know about the scholarship for BSc. Let's see, I right now I don't have any information about, but I will check it to the office and give this kind of fellowships are available or not. But look at the principal sir will also having the orientation, taking orientation course. So I mean to say a kind of address to you people. That time he will definitely mention, okay, about such as scholarships and other things, okay? Around when will be the exam be? Around when will be the exam? This is roughly requires two and a half months so to finish our. We will conduct once the syllabus will be finished and the examinations are going on. I mentioned concurrent evaluation, CE1, CE2, they are continuously. So that's the name, say continuous evaluation. So you're always in the exam mode and always to be, okay? So final exams after the 2.5 months around, you know, completion of the 3 months like that period, you just be in your mind. What will be the learning in a physics in this first year? I mean, which all domains of physics? Learning in physics, generally, we will take in consideration of the syllabus that is given to, first justice is given to the syllabus. We will first finish the syllabus, extracurricular activities by which you can interact with the teachers, okay? That the process of learning also. But this particular domain of physics, I say, whether it's astrophysics or material science or any other field, atmospheric science or any other field if you want to pursue, okay? Theoretical and other things. So let's lot of, I mean to say, domains where we can work out, but just focus right now, start reading those books I mentioned, just like not only the first, like mechanics, we have a thermodynamics, we have a electricity and magnetism, that course. So they're all fundamental courses. Start learning all those books, extra books, okay? You have all reference books. Tentative dates of college reopening. What does it mean, reopening? Yeah, we already opened, but it's a virtual mode. Offline, let's see how the things will be improved, but let's see the positively we will have soon to be you are here in the offline mode. Okay. Ferguson College office is open to visit. Yes, it is open to visit. If you genuinely want to visit, then visit. Okay. Don't take, I mean to say, if the problem is getting solved by the mail or itself, okay, then you can travel and come. How can we contact if you have problems in understanding? You can write email to me. I can write my email ID here. Okay, if you have genuine problem, okay, please write to me. I can send you a message. You can't send a message because you are not a member of the chat. Okay. Right now, I can mention in one of my PowerPoints my email ID. Okay. So next time when I will giving you the PowerPoint, okay. Otherwise, I'll just share. Just a minute. You please write down the email ID of me. Just a minute. If you have any problem, just write by email. Don't phone call. Okay. Most of the time we are, you know, not taking up phones. So just a minute. I'll writing in.
चैट में ईमेल दे दो ना सर आपका फिर.
अरे उधर मैं लिखने जा रहा हूँ लेकिन ले नहीं रहा हूँ. I don't know why there is some problem. Is saying that there's a chat box is off for you. It is mentioned like that. So I just check the.
Actually बता दो.
Right, ASHISH. Right, ASHISH Ashish. And then write dot. Okay. And write the spelling of my surname, Ingantivar. Yengantivar. Yengantivar. At ferguson.edu. Ferguson ka spelling barabar likho.
Sir, you can say again one time.
Yeah, just a minute. I'm writing for you. Don't worry. I'll just sharing so it will be easy to write you people. Okay, some of people.
Sir, chat check karo.
Something is problem with the chat. I don't know because somebody.
Hey, sir, humne dala ek bar dekh lo.
It's okay.
Is it right, sir?
Yeah, it is right. So why there is a question, you can't send messages because you are not a member of the chat. Why it is happening? Because I should be a member, no?
Sir, can you say again one time your email ID?
Yeah, it is written in the chat box. Have you seen the chat box? Please see the meeting chat. The meeting chat, it is a correct email ID. Okay, ashish.engantivar@ferguson.edu. Okay, fine. Yeah, I'll see the chart again. Sir, is not any textbook. Sir, is not any textbook like 11th and 12th. We have to only refer reference books. Yes, like 11th and 12th, you mostly have the, you know, a kind of textbooks. Here we have one book we called as a DS Mathur book, okay, and SC Verma book, but we are not taking completely portion out of it. Okay, remember, this is a selective portions we are teaching to you, like moment of inertia, gravitation, you know, fluid mechanics and the elasticity, the mechanical properties of material. So here we are taking the very selective kind of a thing. So we always take those from the reference book. So don't worry, okay. You just follow the lectures and in the last, I will give you the list of the references from where I have taken. You just follow that book. Okay, but you can write your own notes from the book. And these are all virtual books. E-PDFs are available. I can send you all those materials. Don't worry. Once you have created a team over here and you are having a your Deccan Society.org kind of user ID, then you will access the all such kinds of material. So mostly we will have a classroom team, okay, here, not like a WhatsApp group. WhatsApp group is just for the communication we can maintain, but we're sharing, you know, the materials, the assignments, the classroom notes, PowerPoint presentations. So that we will put it on these class teams. Okay, so we will do this thing definitely soon. Don't worry.
Sir, so we should study like one chapter from five different reference books or something?
Not such a kind of things. Look at which you find better to understand. That is very important. So like I say, if you want to solve the problems on moment of inertia, there are the other bodies where we are going to solve to find, you know, all those MI calculations for each and every body. But some of the books where such a problems are typically given, but most of the reference book, they are solved by, you know, that problem, or there is a certain kind of, you know, particular problem is given in a different way. So that is very important to understand such a types of problems also. So when you are finding, okay, solution of such a different kind of a problem, applied your knowledge to solve some kind of a problem, so then take the reference book. But the understanding, the basic part, that will be remain same throughout. Okay, yeah, the just like a symbols are going to be a change. Formula is remaining same, but just symbol, the Greek letter word, that is only a change. But the mechanics, I mean to say the fundamental, that is remain. But you find the mostly if you want to practice more and more problems, okay, you will find that will be a through the more and more referencing you have across. So that's a very good thing. You have a university physics book, Resnick Halliday book, where we have more problems over there to practice it. Yes.
So we can also use the university physics book throughout the year if you're comfortable with it for all chapters.
Why not? If you're comfortable with that, okay. But suddenly you say, sir, the problem is not us from that level. We have to maintain the level of all BSc students also here, okay. But if you want to practice more and more, you can definitely take those references, okay.
Sir.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, from the last statement, do you want to say, is the university physics books on a higher level or lower level?
Sometimes, you know, they are higher level. Okay. I say some of the, like, you started with the H.C. Verma. Suddenly you come to the D.S. Mathur book. Okay. They find simple in understanding, okay, the way of writing that particular thing, the way it is explained, very easy way. Try to, you know, the Indian language, and that you will find simpler. But once you go to the foreign authors, you will find that the way they have written, okay, quite
My question was from 10th, I'm actually acquainted with these, like, Resnick Halliday's and
good.
I'm just telling with a question level, means if I read from this, am I reading somewhat lower level or higher level? Like,
No, you are built at the right level. Don't call it as a low or high. You are at the right level, okay? But don't call it as a low or high. I say some of the students, we are not acquainted with such a kinds of thing, direct foreign authors. So I say start with the, you know, adopting the things slowly. And those are not acquainted with such a kinds of authors. But now it is opportunity to you people to go through this references book also. Yeah. I say other students.
Main question, sir. Will I get any internships and stuff? Because, like, there was a student who was telling me I can get internship at, like, TIFR and stuff. So are
there are the internship mostly in the second year of BSc. Okay. Once you pass the FI BSc, you are in the second year, not in the third year also. When you are past the first year, you are admitted in the second year of BSc. There are a lot of opportunities of internship, or you say kind of external kind of fellowships are there. Indian Academy of Science is also giving you this opportunity, you people, once you pass the first year BSc. Okay. Are the opportunities.
What will I do there, Minsa, basically?
Generally, in the month of, you know, those period, we are right now in the online mode and pandemic, but generally in the winter session or, you know, summer session, we have a break. Okay, we have finished our semester and just to have, you know, vacation period to start the new semester. That period generally, you people can visit the labs, okay, those funded by the sciences, I mean to say Government of India. So that fellowship is provided by Indian Academy of Sciences to this BSc students. They can work in that period to that labs, okay. And labs means what? Some of the experimental labs also. So you need to write some abstract of work, what you are going to do in that period to that particular mentor who asks, who is going to take the students. Okay. So that kind of internship where you can do experimental work or some kind of a theoretical, typically depending upon the what kind of work is actually going in the lab and the mentor is giving you that direction. So that kind of internship is generally provided. Not industry internship, mostly the industry internship is after your third year of kind of, when you are in the third year, last semester or like that. Okay?
Sir, only one last question. Third year ke baad job milegi ki nahi sir?
Good question. Job kaise rehta hai ki, that is typically on your interest. Okay, if you want to pursue, you want to just see that, okay, mera graduation hua hai, mujhe abhi PG karna hai, aise bhi student rehte hai. Okay, and student want what kind of job they want to do. Okay, since you are in the BSc non-technical mode, you will get like that job, okay, where at your level, okay. And then you are at the MSc level or that kind of a thing, you will get a job. That is, job is not the big question. But what the skills you achieve throughout the years, okay, that is very important. So how you are being good in communication, how good you are writing or personal things and fundamentals and everything, logical understanding. Typically all those, you know, a kind of placement where typically needed those graduate students. But that I already mentioned at the level you achieve, what the graduation. So aisa nahi ki graduation hua hai to mujhe bahut bada job milenga. Okay, that the level and the satisfaction, okay, that you have.
Sir, can we, like, what would be your suggestion to someone who is preparing for exams like IIT JAM and TIFR, IISc, ISERS and stuff?
WhatsApp group is not there, so how can we contact? Okay, problem is understanding, that is also there. Sir, when we will begin with the quantum mechanics? Quantum mechanics, we will begin in the next year, okay? First semester, means third semester of your BSc degree, we will start with the introductory quantum mechanics, okay? So you will learn that in quantum mechanics.
Sir? Sir, no, yeah. Am I audible?
Ayan, yes.
Yeah, yes, sir. So I wanted to ask that I have already done my a course on relativity, both general and special.
Yes,
both. Mm-hmm. And I have met all the prerequisites of learning quantum mechanics.
Correct.
So where should I start learning it? So what is the basic point? See, I have done Lagrangians, then. all the Calabi-Yau manifolds and all that. Every manifold I will do, tensors are done. So at what part should I start quantum mechanics?
Great. Yeah, look at now, the level of the quantum mechanics we are teaching to you, it's very, you know, the essential that we need. So introductory things requires everything. I mean to say, if you visit the quantum mechanics syllabus, the prerequisite you are doing is a very good thing that you probably needed in TY BSc physics, where all those matrix, I mean to say, the operational mathematics that requires, okay, and everything. And you have done additional to that. That's a good thing. But also good thing that you have done special theory of relativity, that is also important. But introductory quantum physics, you can just go through that. And that is enough, okay, right now, at this level. But later on, when the PG and so on, if you want to pursue career in theoretical, you have done more than enough right now for that. But for PG, you have, let's see, in the PG, okay. You probably some of the things which you will be covering the TYBSC kind of a course. Okay, so don't worry.
Okay, sir. And my last question is, I want to pursue my career, especially in astroparticle physics, like particle physics. So what would be the right path to do it?
Yeah, the mostly this particle physics, the nuclear things, you have to be good in both the things, mostly quantum mechanics you have to learn thoroughly, and the nuclear physics part, okay, because that's very important. So in TYBSC we will have that course. I think you will gain the basic essential condition, that requirement for to, you know, carry out your further career in PG physics or later on. Then there is a master course, okay, getting. And if you want to specialize later on some kind of want to pursue a career in a, you know, particle physics or that nuclear physics, you can, you are in the right direction. So don't worry right now. This particle physics, nuclear physics, that you can learn, okay. And hopefully the teachers will give you the advice, okay. You have some questions across that in the TYBSC of physics. So right now, don't worry, okay, too much. You are in the right.
Thank you very much, sir.
एक मिनट है ऋषिकेश, आई विल टेक सम अदर क्वेश्चंस. निखिल, निशिल,
सो दैट वाज मी.
ओके, दैट इज ओके. ओके,
टाइम सर.
ओके, यू डन. आयन, क्रिश, हु इज क्रिश?
हेलो सर.
हां हां,
सो विल वी बी लर्निंग एनी टेक्निकल स्किल्स थ्रू आउट द फिजिक्स कोर्स, लाइक एनी इंट्रोडक्शन टू एनी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज और?
यस, इट इज इन TYBSC फिजिक्स, C programming, C++, MATLAB, and numerical methods that's required in physics, computational physics. But it is in TY. It is in the TY.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine. I think 350 already we reach. Rishikesh, I can take your last question. What is your question?
Sir.
Any suggestion on who is preparing for exams like IIT JAM and ISER and stuff?
So my suggestion is like that, thoroughly prepare what been the syllabus, but try to solve more problems, okay, problem approach of solving some questions. I know theoretical understanding is needed, but trying to solve much and more and problem, unsolved problems of those reference books, okay, Resnick, Halliday, all those, it will be just like Arthur Beiser is one of the book, okay, the quantum mechanics is good in that. So these are the very essential things, okay, required for your any kind of examination. So graduate books, any graduate university books, okay, that will be helpful to prepare, but thoroughly solve those. Mostly the approach is solving the problems.
Sir, the time is up, I guess we have to go, sir.
Time kya?
Time 3:53 ho gaya, sir.
Okay. I'll finish. Thank you.
Question dilo, sir. Last one.
Okay, I will take in the
sir,
next.
Sir, one question. Next.
Okay. Last question, please.
Sir, you gave us the information of the reference books, but which books should we refer if we want some practice of numericals and derivations, etc.? So which books should we refer
for derivation? I told you Mathur, or that book is good for the mechanics part. Numericals, I prefer to have Resnick, Halliday, okay, or university physics book, that is good. Also, S.C. Verma book is good for solving, but theoretical part, you know, derivation and everything, you can take from the Mathur. I will give you, don't worry, all the e-books with me, okay?
And sir, how can we get the access of the university books?
Yeah, I say university books means it's e-copy is available with me, okay? I will provide to you by the Teams only. So I think I want to close the meeting because there may be another meeting. Sorry. Okay.